So yeah, good afternoon. Thank you for having me. So short introduction, I'm Danny Hobo. I'm a backend developer working for Exof, in case you didn't see that yet. I'm from the Netherlands, and I'm working for the Tallinn office. So if you have never seen me before here in Helsinki, that might be the reason why. I'm today talking here about speeding up development with WP CLI, or VP CLI for a bit easier pronunciation. So let's get started. First of all, what is VP CLI? Well, it stands for the WordPress command line interface. And the goal why it was created is so that you can manage WordPress installations from the command line. Basically, the idea is that you can do everything that you can do from the admin interface and more. So how do you get it? Well, as you can see from the steps, it's just three simple steps: download the file and put it into your pod. As you can see, you don't need to install WordPress first. There is a reason for that, because you can actually install WordPress with VP CLI, and that will make things faster, as we will see later. So let's say that you have installed VP CLI and you have a WordPress installation running. Like, let's see at some examples, like what can you do? One good example could be plugins. I mean, we're all using plugins, we're all installing them, updating them. We all know how to do it from the admin. But here's one example how you can do it using VP CLI. So it is just one command. As you can see in my screenshot down below, I was installing the Polylang plugin. Just one command, it automatically downloads, installs, and activates the latest version of Polylang, all with one command. If you want to update like a single plugin, just type in the VP plugin update, in this case, VP plugin update Polylang, and it just, if there is an update available, it just takes that and it immediately like installs it and makes sure that that one is working. How about if you want to update all the plugins? Well, of course, that's possible as well. Just use this command, VP plugin update all, and you can see that VP CLI even puts your site in maintenance mode, updates all the plugins that has an update available, and then takes it out of maintenance mode. I think there is like a small bug in VP CLI because it says updated 3 out of 0 updates, so 3 out of 0 plugins, which of course is a little typo, but as you can see, it has worked. So what other kind of things can you do with VP CLI related to plugins? Well, you can, for example, list all the plugins with status so that you can see which ones are active, which ones are enabled, which ones are disabled. You can install a specific version. So if you want to have an older version of a certain plugin, then that's not a problem. If the latest version of any plugin doesn't work with your site or doesn't work with your team, you can take an older version. If you have a plugin that is not available in the WordPress plugin directory, so some premium plugin, or maybe you're developing something yourself that isn't public yet, you can also just install them from zip or from Git, just the way as you used to from doing it in the admin. And of course, you can also just search the WordPress.org plugin directory so that you can, if you're not completely sure anymore about the name, you can just type it in there and it comes up with all the matches for that name, and you can just install that one directly from the command line. Well, besides plugins, we also all use Teams, or at least many of us do. And basically, that works the exact same way. So instead of VP plugin, you type VP team, and then install the team that you want. You can even add the flag to activate it right away. And as you can see from what I did a 2017 team. It just installs and activates it straight away. So you can all do it with just one command. Well, besides that, it has all the same things that you can do as with the plugin. So you can update them, activate your team, deactivate, install, uninstall, like everything before. So OK, that's like the usual stuff that we all do from the admin. But where can you like really like save a lot of time? Like, what is really the fun stuff? Well, for example, WordPress, the core install can be done in just a few seconds. And that's if you type really fast, but it can be done like very quickly. And you need 2 steps to do that. First, you need to create a VP config file, because of course, WordPress does need to know your database credentials before it does the install. So you just, with one command, can do that as well. VP core config, and then use your database credentials, and it creates the vpconfig file. After doing that, it's just one more command with a few more like parameters, such as the name of your website and the admin credentials. And by doing that, WordPress will be installed. If you do those two steps and you go in your browser to the vchelsinki.dev, you will see that the website is up and running. We all know that WordPress is already fast by default. It is just a 5-minute install, but this makes it even faster. Maybe not, you don't see the value of that if you just do one site, but if you develop 10, 20, 30 websites all on the same server or maybe a few different servers, you can win so much time by just by doing this. The same goes for media. Like pretty much all the websites we develop has a lot of media in it. And you can, of course, you can drag and drop them in the admin, and that goes fast, but why do that if you can just do it from the terminal? If you have all the files already in one folder, just run one command and everything will be imported as attachments to your WordPress site. Well, as we all know, as you develop and you might notice later on that you need to have a few more thumbnail size or like image sizes that are not done yet, you need to regenerate all the thumbnails. I've actually always been doing it like this, so I'm not even sure if this comes out of the box with WordPress. I know for sure there are plugins that can do that for you, but it's not needed anymore because you can just do it with commands from vpcli. In this case, I do like 3 thumbnails because it would take a lot of time to do it all, but if you want to regenerate everything, then you can just do the regenerate all. Comments is, of course, also something. We are all testing our websites. We want to try and see how does this product look like if it has 1,000 comments, like does my lazy loading work, does my paginating work, whatever you're using. And if you manually have to create tons of comments, it's taking a lot of time. Here there is one comment in which you can just do it all. Say which post ID you need to comment for, how many you want. By default, it's 100 comments, but in this case, I did 3,000. If I just open this specific post or product, like in my website, I can see that there are actually 3,000 comments generated. So for front-end developers, this is really useful because it saves you so much time in just like manually inserting comments. Well, now we're talking about comments. We all know that a lot of comments on your production websites, they will be spam if you don't have anything like Google reCAPTCHA or people can comment without login. There will be spam comments. And what a lot of spam plugins do, I mean, I hope we're all using one, they mark comments as spam, but don't delete them yet. So they are clogging up your database. Now, here is one comment where you can, one task where you can see all the comments that are marked as spam. Now, that in itself is, of course, not really useful because, well, why would you want to see which IDs are marked as spam? What can you do with that? Well, you can actually chain the commands in vpcli. So in this case, you can see there is one command where you can delete comments, combine that with a command from the previous slide, and suddenly you have one command that automatically deletes all your spam comments from your website. Might not be useful if you have like maybe 100 or 500 spam comments, but if you're running a big website with thousands, 10,000s, maybe hundreds of thousands spam comments per day, and you need to delete them, you can do it from the admin, but it just takes more time. And here you can do it with one command, everything from the terminal, and you're done. Database, well, as already earlier seen today by, I think it was Edmund who was talking about it, you can use vpcli for database export and import. And he got a really good example, especially with the aliases, which I'm not touching today, but that really works. So I will not say too much about that. But yeah, here are the commands how to do it. And yeah, the search and replace, which we all know like the benefit of that. I have just one extra comment in my very last command. You can actually see that you can add the export parameter to this command. So you can skip one step. From what Edmund showed, you can actually straight away generate a SQL file that already has done the search and replace for you. So Well, I hope that showed a little bit of like the basic commands that come with vpcli. So of course now you want to know, can I create my own custom commands? And answer is simply yes, you can. I mean, just use the vpcli add command in your own plugin, in your own code. And and you can start creating your own vpcli commands in your own plugins so that you can use them for that as well. Vpcli comes with a few global parameters to speed things up a bit more. So loading of skip loading of the themes of the plugins, or if you want to have the PHP debug output, so you can see a bit more like what exactly has been going on or what went wrong. You can prompt the user for the comment arguments if you don't know them exactly by heart, like what can I do, what can I not do. There is a quiet mode so that there is absolutely no output at all. And well, there are more, which you, of course, can all see in the documentation. So, well, to go back to the main topic, like speeding up your development, well, start with like using the built-in commands from vpcli. I mean, you can really save some time with that. Create your own commands, chain them. But the two biggest time savers, and unfortunately, we don't have time to discuss that in a lightning talk like this, is actually the first one is create a script that combines it all. So if you want to create a script that creates a WordPress site and automatically updates all the plugins, you can just create one script and do it all with just one command, or create a script that loops through all the 20 websites that you are managing, and for all 20 websites, just run an update on one certain plugin that you always want to do. And another, like another time saver, is using cron jobs. For example, if you have a script that automatically takes the export from your database from a production website, you can just create like a script that takes it from there, saves it on the server somewhere else as a backup, and have a cron job running it for you. Of course, there are multiple ways to achieve this. vpcli is just one way to do it, but keep that in mind if you're like interested in this stuff. So yeah, the next steps is like basically, if you are interested in all of this, just go to the website, go to the vpcli.org. It's very well documented and constantly like progress going on. And of course, well, you can always like talk to me here or talk to me on Twitter. Like I'm also not the most active tweeter, but I do read all your tweets and I will comment if you have anything. So yeah, that's it. Thank you very much.